In this video, I'm going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet multiplying square roots. Our directions are to simplify. In number one, we have the square root of 5 times the square root of 5. We can combine this. Since they're both under a square root, we can combine. So the square root of 5 times the square root of 5, we can rewrite as the square root of 5 times 5. Which 5 times 5 we can write as either the square root of 25, or you can say the square root of 5 squared, since 5 times 5 is 5 squared. And we know that the square root of 25, or the square root of 5 squared, is that whole number 5, because the square root will cancel out an exponent of 2. So we'll be left with just 5, or you can know that 25 is a perfect square, 5 squared is equal to 25. So the square root is 5. Let's move on to number 2. In number 2, we'll rewrite this. As opposed to saying the square root of 10 times the square root of 2, we'll say the square root of 10 times 2. That's going to give us the square root of 20, and then we'll simplify. We can rewrite the square root of 20 as 2 squared times 5. Because 2 squared is 4, and 4 times 5 is that number 20. So let's split up the radical into the square root of 2 squared times the square root of 5, and the square root of 2 squared is 2, and then we multiply by the square root of 5. 2 times the square root of 5 is the answer in number 2. In number 3, this is very similar to number 1. In number 1, we had the square root of 5 times the square root of 5, which when combined gave us the square root of 5 squared. So for number 3, we'll have the square root of 8 times the square root of 8, which when combined is the square root of 8 times 8, which we can rewrite as the square root of 8 squared, which we know is just 8. And number 4, we have the square root of 20 times the square root of 10. We can rewrite this as the square root of 20 times 10, and that 20 times 10 is within that squared root. 20 times 10 is 200, so we'll have the square root of 200, which we can rewrite as the square root of 10 squared times 2, since 10 squared is 100, and 100 times 2 is equal to 200. That way we can pull out that 10 and get 10 times the square root of 2, since the square root of 10 squared is 10, and the square root of 2 cannot be simplified, so it's the square root of 2. And number 5, the square root of 3 times the square root of 3, we can rewrite as the square root of 3 times 3, which we know is the square root of 3 squared, and the square root of any number squared is that number. So the square root of 3 squared is a positive 3. And number 6, the square root of 5 times the square root of 12. We can rewrite as the square root of 5 times 12. 5 times 12 is 60, so we have the square root of 60. We know that 60 is 4 times 15, so that perfect square that goes into 60 is 2 squared, which is the 4, and that gets multiplied to 15. Then we can write that as the square root of 2 squared times the square root of 15, which the square root of 2 squared is 2, and the square root of 15 cannot be simplified any further, so our final answer is 2 times the square root of 15. In number 7, I'm actually going to start by simplifying the square root of 12. So we have 2 times the square root of 2, and we're going to multiply that by the square root of 2 squared times 3. So that's going to be 2 times the square root of 2, times 2 times the square root of 3. Remember, when multiplying, order doesn't matter, so I'm going to rewrite this as 2 times 2 times the square root of 2 times the square root of 3. So 2 times 2 is 4, and we can rewrite the square root of 2 times the square root of 3 as the square root of 2 times 3. So our final answer will be 4 times the square root of 6, and we cannot simplify down the square root of 6, so 4 times the square root of 6 is our answer. In number 8, I'm going to multiply the square root of 5 with the square root of 2. So I'm going to have 2 times the square root of 5 times 2. Since both the 5 and 2 are under the square root, and we're multiplying those. So now we'll have 2 times the square root of 5 times 2, which is the square root of 10. 2 times the square root of 10 is our answer in number 8. In number 9, we have negative 2 times the square root of 6 times 6. Since the square root of 6 times the square root of 6 is the square root of 6 times 6. So that'll be negative 2 times the square root of 6 squared, which the square root of 6 squared will be 6. So I'll have negative 2 times 6, which is equal to negative 12. In number 10, I'm going to multiply the square root of 2 by the square root of 5. So we'll have negative 2 times the square root of 2 times 5, since both 2 and 5 can be multiplied within the square root. So we'll have negative 2 times the square root of 2 times 5, which is negative 2 times the square root of 10. And this cannot be simplified any further. In number 11, we have the square root of 6 times the opposite, or negative, square root of 9. I know that 9 is a perfect square, so I can rewrite that as negative square root of 3 squared. So the square root of 6 is multiplied to a negative 3, since the square root of 3 squared is 3. And let's just rewrite this as negative 3 times the square root of 6. And in number 12, when I multiply the square roots together, I'll have negative 5 times the square root of 5 times 5, which is negative 5 times the square root of 5 squared. And the square root of 5 squared is 5. So I'll have negative 5 times 5, which gives me a negative 25. So number 12, my solution is negative 25. Go ahead, click the subscribe button, and also don't forget to like this video. Continue on to the next video, where I'll finish out the multiplying square roots worksheet.